Broadcasting from the Princeton Orthopedic Associates Studios in the home of the Zach Gelb Show. This is Fox Sports 920 The Jersey. WNJE Trenton, Philadelphia.
Ready?
It's time to talk sports. National. Local. Professional.
Completely unprofessional.
High school and college.
Let's take it even further off the hook.
It's the Zach Gelb Show.
We are rolling
on Fox Sports 920 The Jersey.
All right, welcome back in. Zach Gelb Show, Fox Sports 920 The Jersey. It is the 5 o'clock hour. And the 5 o'clock hour is, of course, brought to you by our very fine Princeton Orthopedic Associates Studios and also the David Lerner Associates Hotline at 609-919-9200. We are here on the beautiful campus of Temple University, my alma mater, for the home opener tonight between Temple and Wisconsin. And Temple has done a very fine job to start off their season with a 4-2 record, some big wins, had a big game at Madison Square Garden and blew out South Carolina. And now joining us is their head coach, and that is Fran Dunphy. Coach, great to see you. How are you?
Thanks, Zach. Good to be with you.
Well, thank you for coming on. So how about the start to this season? You had the nice little tournament win, and then you had the big game at MSG.
Yeah, the three games in Charleston were terrific. I thought we played pretty well, especially on the defensive side of things. We made shots at the right time. Getting a win at Madison Square Garden is always nice, and against a really good South Carolina team. Obviously, we would have liked to have played a little better against LaSalle and GW, two really good programs who know how to play against us. But we're facing a very difficult challenge tonight against Wisconsin, so we're excited to be back home and again, ready for the challenge of a great program in Wisconsin.
I know you guys get better as the season progresses like any teams, but from the two losses and even some of the games that you won, how can this team get even better even after the impressive start?
Well, you know, the defense has been pretty good other than second half against LaSalle and first half against GW. So I think we want to be there. We want to be really solid on that defensive end as much as we can be. On the offensive end, not turn it over at inopportune times, make good selections in terms of passes and shots, and then we got to step up and do our job when it comes time. So we have to make shots at the right time, and hopefully we'll be ready to go tonight.
Every analyst we talk to, they just love your backcourt and the depth in your backcourt. How do you manage those minutes? And also tell me about some of the kids in the backcourt.
Yeah, I mean, the obviously Josh Brown and Shiz Alston and Quentin Rose are three guys that are getting the bulk of the minutes, and they have some experience. They have some know-how. They've got good size, all three of them. And then we're coming in off the bench with Alani Moore, who in Charleston was just spectacular for us. And now we need to get him back to that point where he's making those shots and making those plays that he's making and doing a better job on the defensive end. We can all do better defensively always. But that's probably the rotation that we'll have. We've given Nate Pierre-Louis some minutes as well. He's done some good things with that. He just needs an opportunity to play. And the longer we get into the season, the more opportunity he's going to get. And all of these guys that are on the bench, they're oftentimes a sprained ankle away from getting their opportunity. And when it comes, you have to do something with it.
Some of the high school coaches I talked to in the area, and then also some of the college analysts that I talked to, they're just blown away by Q and how Q has looked so far this year. Just what makes him so special, and when you watch him play, what is it like to coach a player like that?
Well, he can make plays. He's long, he's fast, he's got some pretty good basketball IQ about him. I think he's working at his handle. You know, the LaSalle game, he struggled handling the basketball. We turned it three times in a very difficult situation in the second half. He has to guard against that. He's shooting the ball much, much better. He worked really hard at that over the course of the summer. And now it's an opportunity to drive it into the gap, get into the paint, and then come to a jump stop and evaluate. Sometimes it's your opportunity. Sometimes it's a kick out for one of your teammates. So he's working on all of those kinds of things. But I think everybody gets wowed by the size and the athleticism.
How has Josh been feeling just coming off the injury? And yeah, I know there's one thing to feel good over the summer, but when you start to play games, it gets a little bit different.
Yeah, I mean, he's not 100%, but I think he's getting closer. You know, I thought today in our workout, pregame workout today, he was alert, quick, on time with every pass and every defensive assignment. So I think he's getting there, but that injury is really a detrimental one, and he's fought hard to come back from it, and I think he's close, but I don't think he's there yet.
Talking with the head coach of the Temple Owls and Fran Dunphy, big home opener tonight nice to be back at home, right, after a very long layoff until the home opener.
Yeah, it's just one of those things that happens sometimes in scheduling. It's one of the more difficult things we do. People will say, why do you do this, this, and this? And sometimes you don't have a lot of choice. It's what's given to you. For us, it's 18 league games. It's 5 city games. It's an exempted tournament. So you don't have that much flexibility in your scheduling. And sometimes it comes down to where you don't start the season for basically 6 days later than everybody else. But that's the way it is, and you learn to live with it, and you manage it as best you can.
I know as a coach, you guys always treat each game one game at a time, and you guys don't look ahead, and you got to be focused on the task in hand. And a program like Wisconsin, what they've been able to do the last few years and in their program, it makes it a little bit easier not to look ahead. But with this tough home opener tonight, and then you also have St. Joe's and Villanova, it's not easy even though you guys return home.
No, it's a phenomenal stretch for us. It's Wednesday, Saturday, and after tonight it's 3 Philly games. And so they will be unbelievably competitive, and we know what we're in for. We watch those teams. We follow those teams. We know all the players, know all the coaches. So it's a phenomenal opportunity, but right now we're worried about Wisconsin, and hopefully we can do a good job tonight.
Wisconsin's had some ups and downs on the early part of the season. That's going to happen when you lose some players like they have, like a Bronson Koenig and also Nigel Hayes. Just how about the Wisconsin team that you see? And also, you got to watch out for Happ, as you know it.
Yeah, well, Happ is one of the better forwards in the country, if not the best forward in the country. So we know what we're in for with that. A bunch of younger guys that are out there playing, but we're really playing against a program. The program of Wisconsin is really a good one and has been for a number of years. I think Greg Gard has done a great job in continuing what Bo Ryan has built. So we know what we're in for. That's a really good win they had the other night against Penn State at Penn State. The Ohio State game before that, Ohio State just made every shot they took in the first half, and it was a difficult time for them. But they learned from that, and they turned around and went to Penn State and got a great win. So they'll be ready to go.
For your team, expectations in the front court, you get Obi back for his senior year. Damian Moore had a good game at Madison Square Garden. How about when you look at the front court of this team?
Well, we need the front court guys, whether it's Earn or Damian or Obi, to do their job, certainly at the defensive end, always rebound the ball, make sure that our guards are not giving up too many drives to the basket, and that they have to step up and take some charges or attempt to block some shots or at least change some shots. They have all that assignment. And on the offensive end, if we're going to make some plays, let's make it from inside rather than outside. So if we get it down inside and defense collapse, then we can kick it back out and hopefully get some good shots for our teammates. But they're doing a good job. But again, this is a whole different test for them tonight.
Wrap it up with Fran Dunphy at the Leah Kora Center. The 4 freshmen, what have you seen from their work ethic and what you've been able to get out of them so far in practice in some games?
Yeah, I think they're all doing terrific. I think it's just a matter of time where they all get their opportunities. And again, it's early in the season, but I think by the end of the year, all 4 of those guys are going to make their mark on Temple's program and certainly give us a great look into the future of what this place is going to be like, our team's going to be like. So I really enjoy coaching them every single day. They work hard. They have a good IQ. And they're great teammates.
Do you like the balance on this roster? You have some upperclassmen, and then you have a lot of youth, sophomore, and then also freshmen?
Sure. I think anytime you can get that mix, that's what you're looking for. For example, we have 4 freshmen this year. We're going to have 2 freshmen next year. So you don't always have a perfect blend of 4 or 3 seniors, 3 juniors, 3 sophomores, 3 freshmen. That'd probably be the ideal. Life doesn't work that way, so there's opportunities that come along. And the fact that we have these 4 freshmen this year, we just need to manage their game, and they need to manage their game as well. But they're all got great futures.
And then I'll end you on this as Fran Dunphy joins us right now with the freshmen. And you know when you bring in a freshman, when they get into a game, they make a shot, they feel great. Mm-hmm. And then when they make a mistake, you're curious to see how they respond to that mistake. So how do you just handle managing a freshman since you've been doing this for a long time and just try to keep them level-headed, in which is a big pressure situation that they get put into their freshman year?
Yeah, well, you work at that every day in practice, and we've had 3 exhibitions / scrimmages to try to work through that with them. So they understand, and they can't get too high after a good play, and they can't get too low after a bad one, and those things are going to happen. You're going to have to live with some of those, but I think they've done a really good job of understanding what their roles are and how they can help the team.
And the game you expect tonight is what?
What game do I expect?
What type of game do you expect?
You know, it's not like it's going to be a running gun. That's not how they play, and that's not really our style either. When we can run, we're going to, but it's not like we're forcing that action. So, you know, it's just one of those. It's going to be a hard fought game, no question about it. Like they played Virginia a couple weeks ago, and that score was in the 40s, and that's. I don't expect it to be there, but I expect it to be in the 60s, and that's just the way they play, you know. So it's and we're similar in terms of our pace. We're both, you know, the mid to low to mid or high 60s in terms of its possession. So you want to get a point per possession, at least that. That's great. We're not averaging that yet. That's what we need to average, and they're averaging a little bit higher than us per possession. So we need to be really efficient tonight.
Well, I appreciate you joining us. Thank you so much, and enjoy the game tonight.
Thanks, Zach.
Coach Fran Dumphy with us. We'll take a break. Zach Gelb Show, Fox Sports 920 The Jersey. Back after this. Looking.